अपना
चालू कर दीजिए वृंदरा जी आप। गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी।
हेलो
यस
हेलो हेलो,
वृंदरा जी
यू आर
बताइए।
गुड आफ्टरनून।
यस हाँ
हेलो हेलो, गुड आफ्टर नहीं, गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ भरूच अंकलेश्वर चैप्टर एज ए फाउंडर चेयरमैन, आई हार्टली वेलकम ऑल द मेंबर ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ अवर चेयरमैन सर श्री आर ए मेहता सर एंड श्री और टुडे स्पीकर हर्ष सर एंड शाह सर, इज प्रोवाइड वेरी गुड अपॉर्चुनिटी टू कंडक्ट दिस प्रोग्राम इन वेरी शॉर्ट पीरियड। सो सच टाइप ऑफ प्रोग्राम वी वॉन्ट टू कंटिन्यू, एंड जस्ट आई वॉन्ट टू ब्रीफ मेक द ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ अवर स्पीकर सीएमए हर्ष देश पांडे सर। हेलो हेलो
हाँ
हेलो,
बोलिए बुंद्रा जी।
सीएमए हर्ष देश पांडे इज प्रैक्टिसिंग कॉस्ट एंड मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटेंट एंड पार्टनर इन मेसर्स हर्षद एस देश पांडे फ्रॉम द प्रैक्टिसिंग सीएमए एंड रेंडिंग प्रोफेशनल सर्विसेज इन द फील्ड ऑफ कॉस्ट एंड मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटेंसी एंड फाइनेंस एंड टैक्सेशन फॉर मोर देन 15 इयर्स। एजुकेशनल बैकग्राउंड इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग। ही इज द फेलो मेंबर ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ कॉस्ट अकाउंटेंट ऑफ इंडिया। ही इज द कंपनी सेक्रेटरी। ही इज सर्टिफाइड इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम ऑडिटर एंड सर्टिफाइड चार्टर्ड मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटेंट फ्रॉम CIMA UK एंड इंसॉल्वेंसी प्रोफेशनल अंडर IBB एंड रजिस्टर्ड वैल्यूअर अंडर कंपनीज एक्ट ऑब्लिक IBB। मास्टर इन कॉमर्स फ्रॉम पुणे यूनिवर्सिटी। प्रोफेशनल इन हिज प्रोफेशनल कैरियर इन एडवाइजिंग नंबर ऑफ गेंट इंडियन कंपनीज एंड मल्टीनेशनल कंपनीज एंड कंडक्टिंग इनडायरेक्ट टैक्सेस जीएसटी कॉस्टिंग फाइनेंस इंसॉल्वेंसी एंड लॉ मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग वैल्यूएशन एंड एडवाइजरी सर्विसेज फॉर दीज कंपनीज एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। एकेडमिशन एंड ट्रेनिंग मिस्टर हर्षद देश पांडे इज क्लोजली एसोसिएट विथ रिप्यूटेड एकेडमिशन इंस्टीट्यूशन अराउंड द पुणे सच एज द सिंगल ए बिजनेस स्कूल MIT स्कूल ऑफ बिजनेस एंड इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस स्कूल लाइक WLC कॉलेज एज विजिटिंग फैकल्टी। मिस्टर देश पांडे हैज कंडक्टेड कॉर्पोरेट ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम फॉर वेरियस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन लाइक रिलायंस इंडस्ट्रीज IPCL एंड सो मेनी अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। रिपोर्ट एंड पुणे चैप्टर ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ कॉस्ट अकाउंटेंट ऑफ इंडिया WIRC ऑफ ICAI ऑन वेरियस फोरम एंड ऑल्सो डन सो मेनी रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ कॉस्ट अकाउंटेंट ऑफ इंडिया आर्टिकल्स। ही वॉज एडिटर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स राइटिंग आर्टिकल्स फ्रॉम वेरियस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन मैगजीन्स लाइक मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटेंट WIRC बुलेटिन MBA रिसर्च जनरल एंड ऑनलाइन पोर्टल लाइक टेक्स गुरु एंड CA क्लब एंड हैव रिसीव्ड मोर देन 20K हिट्स। एडिटर ऑफ WIRC बुलेटिन ऑफ आवर इंस्टीट्यूट मंथली नॉलेज शेयरिंग बुलेटिन ऑन द इंस्टीट्यूट फॉर लास्ट मोर देन 5 ईयर। हेलो हेलो,
उनको आपकी आवाज आ रही है? एम
यू आर हियरिंग मी?
आई ऑडिबल?
मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटेंट अकाउंटिंग एंड ABCNI। ही इज वास्ट एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ इन कॉस्ट मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग एंड प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी एनालिसिस वर्टिकल। ही इज हैविंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट इन इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ SAP को फॉर द नंबर ऑफ क्लाइंट एंड हैविंग प्रोवाइडिंग रिटेनरशिप सर्विसेज मेजर इंडस्ट्रीज वर्क इंक्लूडिंग ऑटोमोबाइल इंडस्ट्री एंसिलरी फूड FMGC टेक्सटाइल स्टील मिल्क इंजीनियरिंग पावर ज्वेलरी कंस्ट्रक्शन EPC एंड अदर सो मेनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। वैल्यूएशन ही इज कंप्लीटेड मोर देन 100 वैल्यूएशन असाइनमेंट फॉर वेरियस पर्पज लाइक फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ शेयर्स मर्जर अमलगमेशन एंड सो मेनी अदर इंसॉल्वेंसी प्रोफेशन लिक्विडेशन एंड स्ट्रेटेजिक डिसीजन फॉर क्लाइंट ऑफ वेरियस सेक्टर्स इंसॉल्वेंसी प्रोफेशन। ही इज हैंडलिंग मेनी असाइनमेंट एज ए IRP / RP लिक्विडेटर फॉर कॉर्पोरेट having experience from 1 crore to 2000 crore, he has successfully resolved so many cases. Technology is handed over experience of various ERP like SAP, Oracle, any Navision, and also work with Ed like Congo SAP and other seminar reporting tools. He has been part of system audit team. Extra career, he is also working for so many social organizations. CMA Arthur Deshpande is elected as a regional council member from WRC of ICAI. Presently, he is treasurer of WRC of ICAI. Earlier, he has occupied secretary of the Pune chapter of Cost Accountant of India as well as treasurer of Pune chapter of Cost Accountant. He is involved in so many seminars and he is a very dynamic member. First, he has attempted all type of courses, just like IP, ID, Independent Director, Registered Valuer. Those are developed in last 3-4 years. So we really, really welcome our today's speaker. And I will hand over my mic to our today's speaker. Also, I am thankful on behalf of Bharuchla Ankleshwar chapter of all the members who are joining this seminar as well as other members. Thanks very much. I hand over this speaker to our today. Any today's speaker, Mr. Arthur Deshpande ji. Also, I thankful to Viral Shah sir, who is arranging such type of good any technical arrangement for our member to enrich our knowledge in COVID-19 lockout time. Thank you very much to all the members. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mundra ji, for my detailed introduction and giving me this opportunity to take up this topic of independent director. So let me also congratulate this team members of Bharuch Ankleshwar chapter. You are a very young chapter and you are doing such a good initiatives. I'm really, really happy for it. And we should be working more closely in order to become successful professionals. And together, if we stand, then we are united, we can do wonders. So thank you very much. I also congratulate Mundra ji that he has successfully passed this examination. In fact, last session I had made this webinar, he was there, he asked me certain questions and immediately I asked him to appear for the examination and the result was favorable. So we are very happy to see Mundra ji as a good kind of icon that somebody has taken this initiative and passed examination. So with this I would like to start this presentation. I'm sure you must have been seeing my presentation on your screen, so which I will be sharing. So I am also at home, so you can see my background perhaps more colorful than any office atmosphere. So I also request you that since I'm at home, so if any disturbance is there, distraction is there of the family members, kindly excuse me for that. So I request everybody to take care of yourself and also your family. Let's hope that this lockdown period be ended soon and we are safe to back what it was. But it looks like the days are are going to get extended. So what to do in such times? That it is the best time that we can channelize to do certain things which perhaps we are not doing but we think that we should do. So this is for that, it's a very good time. So one such type of thing that we should do is that increase our knowledge base. It's been long time that after passing this examination, professional examination, we are not again gone back to the days of studying, and we are somehow lost the touch being into the back to the academics. So this is a very good opportunity that we should utilize in this period, and we should be we should seek for the more knowledgeable resources. We should look out for the better opportunities. One thing also I would like to point out that post this lockdown period also, there is a talk which is going on, is that there is going to be a impact on this business. There will be impact on the businesses. There will be impact on the professionals. There will be impact on the employees. and we all should be geared up to be adaptable such to such situations. So it's always better to have the different, you know, you must have been seeing Raman, that Ram has already has so many weapons under his arm, so we can use the which one he want to. So for that, first thing, he should have the weapons with him. So likewise, as a professionals, we should also have weapons, perhaps in the form of the professional qualifications and expertise and the knowledge which can be utilized in the days to come. The days definitely are going to be challenging. There is a long talk about that the impact is going to be there for how much tough time. So this is a very good opportunity, and I was just going through some of the invention of this gravitational forces also was being done in the such lockdown period when it was being invented. So every such pandemic results into a deterioration of the wealth of the stakeholders. It results into a recession, slowdown, or depression. So we all should be geared up for that. And so with this, I would like to just start up this topic of independent director and what is the opportunity for professionals, what we can make out of it. So already this introduction, my introduction has been given by Mundraji, so I will not go into that. So you can see my professional qualifications and the experience. So now just remember the days when we started our this profession or professional courses. So somebody would like to become, you know, manager, general manager, or a CFO, or somebody wanted to become a top ladder in the management or something like that, isn't it? Now that time has come that you must have realized that there is a, once you reach the senior level in the management, there is a one step above is the board of directors, or the board, what we normally used to call. So this perhaps is the opportunity for you to just jump the ladder and, you know, get a quick accelerator growth, especially those who are in the employment, that instead of just lining up for this the higher positions in the management grade. So why not to become, you know, a board member and, you know, be a step above of all. So this is one more very good thing that you can see about this being the independent director. So you can see the pic what is being shared on this first slide. You can see that all this chairs are in the same direction, but except one chair which is marked in red. So which is not in the same line of the other chairs. So that is what the role of the independent director is, that you should not be a kind of a yes man, but you should be looking out for, you know, independent thought process, and the you should be open to criticize or to justify or to ask for more information about certain decisions perhaps the board want to take, which is in the interest of the shareholders. So what is the independent director? What is the role of the independent directors? So he should act as a guide, coach, and mentor to the company. So his role is more of, you must have been aware at the time of when we were doing our inter or foundation, we were, there is a staff function and there is a line function. So perhaps the role of the independent director is more of a staff function. So his role is more to see that the things are being done in the right way, rather than we always say that doing things rightly or doing right things. So he's more of for doing right things. So one has to be, his role has to be more on the seeking the vision and achievability of the corporate objectives. So he should help the company in improving the corporate credibility and governance standards. So these days, corporate credibility is also very important. You must have been seeing even this days of this COVID, the people are talking about credibility of corporates. Some of the corporates, you know, which are doing well in the business, but what about their credibility? You must have been seeing the so many examples of, you know, Ratan Tata and Tata Sons and other players vis-a-vis the other MNCs. So that improves the corporate credibility. And this corporate credibility also gives you a kind of a mileage we can see that the people are more acceptable or to become the employees of such companies, or they are proud to be employees of such companies. The company also uses its the name and fame in order to make the environment more social friendly and enjoy the benefits of being into such category. Also the governance standards. So governance standards not only talks about, rather it also gives a lot of advantages to the company, not only the indirect advantages or only the kind of branding, but also it gives the cost advantages. For example, if a company who is having a very good corporate governance standards, if it goes for you know, additional funding, so suppose it approaches a bank, the banks are also very happy to give the lending to such companies in the cheaper rate or lowest possible rates. Similarly, if a company want to go for suppose equity participation and or they want to have private equity in place or investor in place, so in such cases, if a such company which is having a better governance standards, of course there are chances are for the probability of getting such equity stakeholders or investor is much higher. So of course it gives them a lot of cost advantage as well. You must have adequate knowledge about the company and the external environment in which it operates. So he should be, although he is independent, he should not be independent of the company. He should be well within the company. He should be knowing good, he should be having a very good knowledge about the company. And also he should have the external environment in which it is operating. So we should act independent director's role is to act as the external check to make sure that the environment in which the company is operating and the company's performance, they are being aligned. Report the matters concerning the unethical behavior, actual or suspected fraud or violation of company's code of conduct or ethics policy. Now this you must have been, if you recollect the days in late 1990s, certain frauds like Enron and other companies, so these were detected. So in such cases there was a questions being raised that what the board is, the role of the board, and at that time also this the concept of this independent director was being discussed a lot. So perhaps a board member or independent directors, he will have a better understanding, and he perhaps, since he's independent, he can dare to say or the report the matters which are, you know, concerning the unethical behavior or any suspected fraud or any violation of code of conduct. There is a long history about this provisions being in force. So if you could remember the early days where this Cadbury committee was being formed, so there was a committee being set up in order to improve the corporate governance standards. So also in 2006 there was such committee being set up in so there is a corporate governance standards, the SOX. So these are the all the milestones to see the provisions of independent director getting stronger and stronger. And now it is in the statute in the form of Companies Act 2013. Safeguard the interest of all stakeholders, particularly minority shareholders. So his role is also to ensure that this the interest of the stakeholders is being protected. What happens is that why this corporate governance is required, because you will see that in the corporate structure, there is a distinction between the ownership and the management. So the one who has invested the money, he may or may not be in the management of the business. So what it can happen is that these two parts can have a different objective. You must have been studied this wealth maximization versus profit maximization approach. So this thing should not happen. So the role of the independent director is also to make sure that he safeguards the, particularly the minority shareholders. Applicability, listed companies. So what the law says that basically this Companies Act 2013, in which these provisions are being enacted of the independent directors. So what it says that it all the listed companies should have the independent directors. How much? So if it's section 149(4) talks about, they should have at least 1/3 of total number of directors as independent directors. So suppose the company has 9 directors, so 3 directors should be independent. That is what the law says. Of course, there is one more provision which says that if the chairman is executive chairman. So in such cases, the number of directors should be half of the number of directors. So if your chairman is a executive director, so in that case, half of your board should be independent directors. The audit committee shall consist of minimum three directors who are independent directors. So audit committee is a very important committee of any listed company. So all these financial statements and they has to go through the audit committee, which independently studies the integrity of the financial statements, because the investors or the stakeholders, they believe the financial statements to be true and fair. So if the financial statements doesn't reflect what the business is doing, so in such cases there could be issues pertaining to the corporate governance, and the stakes of the investors or the shareholders may be at a risk. So every audit committee will have three directors which are independent directors. The audit committee must and shall consist of 2/3 of the members to be independent directors. That is as per the SEBI listing obligations and disclosure LODR requirements, regulations 2015. So 2/3 of your audit committee should consist of the independent directors. So how many such companies would be there? So in India around, you will see that there are around 7,000 odd listed companies are there. So 7,000 company, if you take minimum either three as the directors, you will see that this number of independent directors required will be somewhere 21,000, right? So you will see that the number of opportunities are there for the companies to select the independent directors. Then public companies, if the paid up capital is greater than 10 crores, or the turnover is greater than 100 crores, or the aggregate outstanding loans, debentures and deposits are more than 50 crores. So if your paid up capital is more than 10 crores, or your turnover is more than 100 crores, or your debts in the form of loans or debentures or deposits are greater than 50 crores. So in such cases, at least two directors should be independent directors. So you will see that this number of companies fulfilling such criteria. So it's estimated that more than 10,000 companies would be fulfilling such criteria. So if you take this number 10,000 and multiply by at least two directors, so you will again see that this perhaps 20,000 number of independent directors will be required. So let's look at the board of, you know, a company like Infosys. The company like Infosys has 8 independent directors on their board. So I will not go to that number, but even if a company has 2, 3, or 4 independent directors, you will see that this requirement of independent directors would be really at you know, at its peak, at least in the first year of implementation of this. So what is the qualification? Who can become the independent directors? So that is being described under section 149(6) of the Companies Act. A person of integrity and possess relevant expertise or experience. Not a promoter of the company. So any promoter, he cannot become the independent directors. He should not be related to the promoters or directors of the company. So he should not have any relationship. So relationship in terms of it is also being defined under this Companies Act, what he can be treated as a relative of the promoter or directors. So any relationships is there, so that will make you ineligible to become the promoter. Has no of relationships in fact, should not have any financial or commercial relationship with the company. Should not have any pecuniary relationship with the company. In fact, that is being well defined under this section 149(6). So I will not take your time into go into details of such provisions. So you can just check offline what are the how they have defined these relationships that is being well defined under Companies Act. None of whose relative is holding any security or interest in the company. So even if your relatives are holding any security or interest of the company, so in such cases you are not eligible to become the independent director. Not holds the position of key managerial person. So you, if you are employee or you are a key manager person of a company, then you yourself cannot become a suppose a company as a finance director. So he himself, even though he may get qualified as an independent director, so he will not be able to serve that company as an independent director because he is holding the KMP position. In fact, the rules also says that you should be 3 years if you are, there has to be a cooling period of 3 years once you are a KMP of a particular company. Director shall possess appropriate skills, experience and knowledge. So you should have appropriate skills, experience and knowledge. You should not be indebted to the company. So you should not due, you should not be indebted to the company or not given any guarantee or provided security in connection with the indebtedness of the third person to the company. So on behalf of somebody else, you shouldn't have given any guarantee to the company. So these are the qualifications. You will see that this section doesn't prescribe any formal educational qualifications. The point remains is that why it is not there, because there are so many people who may have the relevant expertise and experience. Suppose somebody is in a, you know, a very good technical person, somebody, you know, is an agriculturalist, so who may or may not have a formal stream of education, so that should not held up them to become the independent directors. So there is no formal education prescribed to become the independent directors. So anybody who wish to become independent director, he can become, but his name should appear in the database of the independent directors. So it is not only just you should have this qualification that is being under section 149(6) of the Companies Act, but your name should appear in the database. So this MCA has started with this database of the directors. So what you have to do is that you have to enroll yourself, pass the small examination, that self-assessment examination. So once you pass the examination, then your name will appear in the database as a eligible director. Then only you can become the independent director and serve as an independent director of the company. Exemption. So there is an exemption that somebody who is having the experience of more than 10 years as a KMP, or you have served as a director for the period more than 10 years on the date of the inclusion in the name of database of any listed public company or unlisted company having share capital of 10 crores or more, or a body corporate listed on the stock exchanges. So if you are already having such experience, so in such cases, there is exemption given for this proficiency self-examination test. When this provisions will get started, in fact, there was a when this company's appointment and qualification of directors rules 2014, the amendment was being published. So at that point of time, this was to start from this April, but there is an extension, and instead of 3 months, the words 5 months has been prescribed. So this was being notified in the December. So we are expecting that this appointment of independent directors will be made applicable and effective from the May 2020. First choice, of course, would be the ones who have passed this examination. So it's very important that you utilize this time to pass this examination, and thereafter you will be eligible to get on the board of some of such listed companies or public companies. Now let's look at the statistics. So as on 28 March 2020, so total 14,815 people, they were enrolled themselves to become the independent directors. Out of that, 2,591 were a woman independent director registered. The companies registered were 1,274, and people who have passed the online proficiency self-examination test are 1,214. So you will see that out of 14,815 people, only 1,214 people have passed this examination as of now. So there is a also you will see that this number of companies and the people who are eligible to become the independent, the ratio is very positive. It may, in fact, just 1:1 ratio is there. So if a company want to have a 2 or 3 independent directors, perhaps there is a shortage of such professionals which are being available. I also would like to highlight this woman independent directors. because there is a one more notification issued last year, which mandates that the public company should have at least one director who should be a woman director, and she should be heading this committee of POSH. So there is a requirement of woman also on board. So if there's somebody, especially girls or women who are there present, so there for them it's a very good opportunity that a company may select you, so that in one single appointment they can fulfill the two or three provisions of the company act. So there is a very good opportunity for women independent directors in the days to come. The empanelment of independent director on database. So what is the procedure? So on the right hand side, you can see that I have written the step. Step one is to log into the MCA portal. On the MCA portal, there is a tab called as a ID data bank registration under MCA services. So you can click on that and also click on the individual registration. So individual registration means the person who want to enroll himself as an individual who can become the independent director. So there is one more tab, that is the corporate registration or company registration. So company registration will be for the companies who want to appoint or who want to see this data bank as to who is empaneled or to become the independent directors. So you should select the individual registration, then enter your DIN, PAN or passport details and click on submit button. Here if you don't have a DIN number, director identification number, or a DSC, that is also okay. You can obtain this later on, so it's not a mandatory to have a DIN or DSC. Passport also, if it's available, good. If it is not available, still it doesn't stop you. Just you have the PAN card, that is sufficient enough to get yourself registered. So the enter email and mobile number, and you will get the OTP. So you can verify the OTP. After that, you will get a link for this username and password. So you can get the login credentials on this MCA portal. So that is the procedure on the MCA. So once you have done that, then the second part would be to do the procedures under independent directors portal. So automatically you will be redirected to the independent directors data bank portal. So I've just there are small steps. That is the step one is to log into the independent directors portal, then fill the profile with the personal education and experience details and submit the declarations. Generally, if in a profile we have to fill up, what we do is that we do the mandatory fields that we fill. But here I will request that everybody should give a lot of devoted a lot of time on the filling this profile, because this profile would be visible to the people or to the companies who would like to seek the appointment of the independent directors. So you should be it is like your own resume or CV. So fill this profile with your all the details about your education and experience, so that it will be easy for the companies to identify you as a potential independent director. And after submitting the details, you have to pay the subscription fees. So the subscription fees are 5,000 rupees plus GST for 1 year subscription, 15,000 for 5 years, and 25,000 for lifetime. So you can choose one of the three options. So initially there is also update which is available. So what you can do is that you can first choose the individual 1 year subscription of 5,000 rupees plus GST. So after that, once you qualify or you have the appointments in hand, so later on you can update yourself to a 5 year plan or a lifetime plan. So that is also very much possible. So once you have done this, after that you have to schedule your self-assessment examination. So there is a tab which will allow you to schedule your examination. So it is there are slots which are available. So on the basis of available slots and what is being convenient to you, you can schedule your examination. So for this process of empanelment, you should have the valid DIN, PAN or passport. So as I said, that even if you just have PAN number, that is sufficient enough for you to start this process of empanelment. Registration on the MCA portal, complete the process of in this MCA portal. After that, complete this process at the ID data bank. So this is what you have to do. So this opportunity also comes with the responsibilities. Now you can see in this pic, lot has been talked about the independence of directors. So you will see that some of the directors perhaps would like to talk something, but they may or may not be allowed to talk. So that perhaps is a big question that you will see a lot of articles on this, that whether the independent directors are really independent. So that is also a very big question. The role of independent directors, especially the companies which are under controversies. So you will recollect in 2006 there was a case of Satyam, wherein before in fact this Satyam scam got into the public domain, it was being the some months before there was a big acquisition of Satyam wanted to make in a company called as Mitas, which was its subsidiary companies. So Satyam, if you spell it the reverse order, that was the name of the company, MYTAS, Mitas. Okay, so at this acquisition was so heavily valued. So some of the independent directors raised these questions about this acquisition. Is it related? Is it the money worth spending? So at that point of time, three independent directors have resigned because they were of the opinion that this deal should not be there in order to protect the interest of the Satyam. Okay, so they have resigned. So in this scenario also, that role of the independent directors was being much being discussed. Then recently this Satyam case, this Tata Sons case, when this Cyrus Mistry was being removed from the chairmanship of this Tata Sons. So at that time also there was a lot of talk about the independent directors and their role. And in fact, you will see a lot of this NCLT or NCLAT pronouncements wherein this role of independent director is very well discussed. And also this recent case of this Yes Bank, wherein again this credibility or this role of the independent directors is being questioned. Liability of the KMP under Companies Act. So you are being director, so you also become a key managerial person. And the liabilities which are there for the KMPs under Companies Act becomes applicable to you. So one has to be very careful about this. So this opportunity is both ways. This opportunity also comes with a lot of responsibilities. So one should be very careful with respect to. I'm telling you this because I would like you to have a full view of the profession. It is not like just opportunity, but also you have to look at what is the upside and also what is the downside. What are the liabilities of independent directors? So provisions of the Companies Act 2013 and SEBI listing norms say that the independent directors can be held personally liable for any acts of omission, commissions by the company with his knowledge, consent or convenience, or in cases where he had not acted diligently. Okay. Therefore, independent directors typically quit and seldom cite the reasons or reason behind such their decisions. However, there are certain exceptions. For instance, this R. Chandrasekhar of Yes Bank and Anil Khandelwal of JM Financial ARC cited the lack of governance as the reasons to step down. While Chandrasekhar quit due to the governance concerns and the management of the company affairs, Mr. Khandelwal cited this variance in the corporate governance principles as the reason of his resignation. So I would like to just bring article to your notice, that LiveMint has published an article. The number of independent directors exiting without adequate reasons has been growing on year-on-year basis. Why independent directors are rushing for the exit door? So this was the article. Out of 743 independent directors who vacated their positions on the board of the listed companies, 561 exited without adequate reasons before the end of their terms. Now that same article has given the reasons. What are the reasons they have given for this resignation? So there are 2 years, 2017 and 2018. The orange one is 2017. The blue one is 2018. So demise, there were 42 cases. Then non-attendance to the board meetings, 3 cases. Not interested in the reappointment, there was no case. In 2017, it was 1 case. Resigned due to health reason, 32. Resigned due to old age, 13. Resigned due to personal reasons, 140. resigned due to preoccupation 124, resigned without no reason stated are 297, resigned to join another board 1, retired superannuated or term expired 18, suspended 1, vacation of office and not in, not known are 2. So you'll see that the reasons, the majority reasons, first is that resigned with no reasons, resigned with preoccupation, without quoting what the preoccupation is, and resigned due to personal reasons. So these are the perhaps the reasons for that, these are reasons given, but you will see that these are not the real reasons. So you'll see that this majority of the reasons, these are not the reasons perhaps could have been there for the exiting such opportunity. Clarification, thus there was a circular on this 2nd of March 2020 just recently about this clarification on the prosecutions filed or the internal adjudication proceedings initiated against the independent directors, non-promoter, non-KMP, non-executive directors regarding. So there was a very good clarification, because you will see that so many independent directors, they being identified as a KMP, they were subject to a lot of civil and criminal prosecutions, and many of this such directors were saying that they were not party to certain decisions. In fact, certain decisions were not to their notice. So why in that cases he should be held responsible? So this circular, it says, the main part of the circular says that section 149 is a non-absente clause which provides that the liability of the independent directors or non-executive directors not being a promoter or a KMP would be only in respect of such acts, omissions or commissions by the company which has occurred with his knowledge attributed to the board process and with his consent, conveyance or where he had not acted diligently. In view of express provisions of section 149(12), the IDs, that is independent directors, and NEDs should not be arrayed in any criminal or civil proceedings under the act unless the above mentioned criteria is met. So what it says is that if the criminal and the civil prosecution can be filed only in cases when the independent director has his consent, conveyance, or he has not acted diligently. So once you are fair enough to have the documentation in place which says that any act is not with your consent, or you are not agreeing to certain and which has been duly recorded, or you have not acted diligently, so in such cases you have to make sure that you have sufficient document so that you will not be held for any prosecutions, either civil or criminal. So that gives a lot of clarity and a lot of immunity to the independent directors in case of such, you know, acts which will unnecessarily trigger the litigation against him. That is a welcome clarification by the government, which enable now this independent directors, which otherwise, you know, it's very risky. It used to be an independent director of any company, because you are held responsible for that for which you are not party. But this clarification definitely gives a lot of relief to the independent directors. Now, independent director examination, the early bird benefit, of course, as I see in the statistics, that ratio of independent directors versus company, now just the ratio is 1:1. So you will see that in the month of June, when this provision will actually be triggered, you will see that a lot of company would like to participate, and they would like to have the independent director on board. So definitely there is going to be a early bird benefit. Second most important thing is that you can appear from this appear from the home. So this is the computer based examination, so you can log in from your own desktop or laptop, and any desktop or laptop who has got a sufficient hardware, that is the webcam and microphone, so that is enough for you to appear from your home. So you did not go to any examination center. So even if this lockout days, you can appear for this examination and pass this examination. So that's the reason you will see that, for example, our Mundra ji has passed this examination just a couple of days back. So you can take the advantage of this examination pattern, and you can appear and utilize this days. Otherwise, once this will be over, again, you will be back to what it was, isn't it? new rules, regulation, notifications are expected. So as the things will move on, you will see that there are new rules, regulation, notifications are being issued. So once it has been issued, that becomes part of your syllabus, so that you add to your the study content, you becomes higher and higher. So as it goes on, so your efforts get you have to put some more efforts. So that's the reason that it's always better to qualify it as early as possible. In fact, I had qualified on the first date of this examination. So it was being first examination was scheduled on 1st of March. So I appeared for this first examination on that date. I could qualify myself. So what is examination? It has a MCQ, multiple choice question. So one question, there will be four answers. So you have to choose the correct answer. So there are 50 questions and time allotted is 75 minutes or 1 hour and 15 minutes. Generally, this time is sufficient enough for you to answer all the questions. There are 25 MCQs which are on the board essentials, which are direct questions. So these are the typically questions directly on the law, either in the form of corporate governance standards or SEBI laws or, you know, section 149 of the Companies Act. So these are the direct questions. And 25 questions are scenario based or a kind of a case studies about the board practices. The passing rate is 60% and there is no negative marking. So that is also one very good advantage, that there is no negative marking. So somebody has got a good luck, he can also try to become the and pass this examination and become the independent director. So what are the steps to enroll on this IIC website and pay the fees? So this portal, that is independentdirectorsdatabank.in, you can go and enroll yourself. After enrolling, you schedule your examination. Generally what happens is that people tend to first take a call that okay, I will go through the material, then I will see what is the syllabus, then I will prepare myself, then I will schedule the examination. So perhaps that goes on delaying because you don't devote the time for the studies, or you have some other priorities, so you keep on doing it. So my request would be that don't do and don't go by that approach. Rather, once you pay the fees, immediately schedule your examination as early as possible. So once you schedule your examination, automatically you will be motivated to make sure that you give your best attempt and you automatically start studying. So my request would be that you should enroll as early as possible and also schedule your examination as early as possible. There is no separate fees for examination. So once you pay that 5,000 rupees, that is all, you can schedule a number of attempts until you pass the examination. Download Act rule regulation. So a lot of material is available on this. You can download this Companies Act, SEBI regulations, rules. So that all is available on the website. So even though books are not available, that will not stop you to study this for this and prepare yourself for this examination. Go through the courses available on the portal. So this IIC website or this data bank portal is also good enough. So there are certain courses or the videos or presentations are there, so which are very good. So you can take the benefit of that, and that also will complete your course, and also that will make you prepared for this examination. Take a mock test. So there is a small mock test which is also available on the website. So that mock test will also test that whether you have got adequate hardwares or softwares so as to you are geared for the examination or not. So you can take that a mock examination. So there are certain questions are there, so that questions will enable you to know that what are not going to come in the examination. So because these are the mock tests, so that we may or may not come to the examination. And of course, pass and share the results. So perhaps many of us have not, when we have passed the examination, we didn't have this any social media to share. Now there is opportunity for us to, have that joy again. So I request that once you pass also, share and also share with me so that I will be happy, so that there are already 20-25 people who have passed this examination, and I was really very happy to note that they have shared that, sir, your presentation has helped us to prepare for this examination. And that is the kind of feedback or the best feedback I get when I receive such appreciation. Be selective with the assignment. So once you qualify and then you can take maximum 7 assignments as independent directors. So you have to be selective, and as I said that you also have to look at the you also look at the responsibilities. So you have to be very very careful about what you wish to choose as assignment. So once you have done that, you will be seeing this happy faces as you can see in this pic, and become, you know, a successful independent actor. So any questions are there? We can take up.
Hello, all the participants are requested to please share their questions.
There is also small case study which is there, but I think we are just rushing to the time. So I would like to take the first the question and answer, then we can, the time permits, I can take up the case study. So I'll just take up to the sum up slide. So as a cost accountant, we are being well versed with this Companies Act, so that is advantage to us. The CSE, MSES are recognized to become the independent directors with the mix of the operational business and also having this commercial or the financial expertise. The professionals are having the edge in this evolving profession. The professionals can appear for this limited examination and take the benefit of this new avenue, and to become the part of the top of the ladder. So you can be you know, a top of on the board of any company. So that is what the opportunity is there for the professionals. Okay, so with this I just would like to thank all of you and also open up for the question and answer session. In case if anything I have not covered, please feel to, there is a chat box in this your this login, so you can ask the question on this chat box, so that I will be getting know that if I have not covered anything. So also if you can just, if you feel later on also, you can just connect with me either through on the email, you can send me your email, or you can connect me on the Facebook or LinkedIn, or you can also join my Twitter handle Harshal_DE, and I will be very happy to help you. Also, you can follow my articles which are there on the CA Club India or taxguru.in about this independent director valuation or insolvency professionals. So this is what I would like to say. Any questions are there, you are most welcome. Not seeing any questions, so perhaps one question definitely you would be interested to know is that once I become independent director, so what is the remuneration expected? Okay, so independent directors can be paid a remuneration, he can be paid a sitting fees, he can be paid even a commission on the sale or on the profits, that is allowed. Only one thing is not allowed, that is the stock options. So you will not be entitled to any ESOP or, you know, any stock options being independent directors. So you have to maintain that in order to secure that you are independent, your position stands independent and you are not related to any promoter group. So sitting fees can be paid. So maximum sitting fees can be paid is 1 lakh per sitting. So that is what the Companies Act prescribe. But other than that, the companies can pay you as a remuneration or in the form of any other medium, so that is also being allowed. So it all depends upon how what is your profile and what is your credentials and what is your expertise, so you can add the value to the company. So based on that you will get paid by the company. Okay, friends. So thank you very much.
Hello.
For your
question. I want to ask one question. I want to ask one question. Those are female candidates who are qualified person, they can get maximum benefit in this course because there is no very less independent directors, and also the board is required independent directors for as per Companies Act. So I request that the female participants should be join this course from CMS side. So our participation should be maximum in this profession.
Yes, also, and one more point I would like to highlight is that especially practicing females, you know, for them it's a very good opportunity. For that matter, you know, any practicing professional. So if you are practicing CMA, still you can engage yourself into the appointment of independent directors. That is completely allowed by the code of conduct. So you can continue your present practice, and you can still become the on the board of as an independent director of a company. In the employment also, you can become the independent director of another company, not of the same company or not of the any promoter or the subsidiary or holding company. But provided your company should allow you to accompany or should allow you to take such positions. So the law point of view, there is no debar, but you have to take care of your own company rules and regulations.
Hello, any question? Yes, sir. Hello, any question from any participants? Hello, then I request our chairman sir, CMA RA Mehta sir, to provide this opportunity. I request him to give the vote of thanks, or otherwise I have to give the vote of thanks. Respected all the participants, their today's session was very good, and the Akshat Deshpande sir explained very nicely how to become the independent director. Also he explained that today is the great requirement of independent directors, so maximum cost accountant, chartered accountant, company secretary should join this course and qualified. After that there is a their choice if they want to become the director or not want to become the director. Fees is very less, so I request maximum participants to try to attempt this examination and fill the form. First they fill the form, then everything is possible. So don't waste time for thinking. Or also I thankful to Arshad Deshpande sir, who immediately before 3 days they accept that I will provide this Bharuch and Lesser chapter such type of seminar. That was any pending from very long time, that personally seminar, but this COVID-19 for lockout period is provide very good opportunity to how to become the independent director. Also I request Arshad Deshpande sir, in future we will try for IP also, independent insolvency professional. For that we should learn how to pass this examination. There are the any matter, only one and two seminars should help to our profession as well as other profession. And our Bharuch Ankleshwar is a such type of location. We are having an expert in GST also, sir. Rati sir, Sachana sir, or Mehta sir is very dynamic. Every time they think about our chapter, and our chapter is going nicely. So I request Arshad Deshpande sir to provide such type of opportunity in future also. Thankful to all the participants to spare their valuable time to attend a small seminar in big way. Thank you very much, Arshad sir. I also thankful to our Sa sir, Mr. Virat Sa sir. He is nicely working with me for last three hours, that how to conduct this program. This was the first program for our chapter and for my life also. So everything is possible, so we should try to pass the examination. Thanks everybody, especially thanks to Arthur sir and all the participants of Bharuch, Ankleshwar, Baroda and any other who attend this seminar. Thanks.
Thank you very much all. See you. Take care.
Thank you very much. Thanks all. Thank you.